G'day guys, welcome back to Star Wars Vault Unleashed episode 11. Today we have a very, very, very special guest from Lismore, New South Wales in Australia. And he might be a bit of a familiar face to you. If you have seen him, yes, you have seen him before. He's on YouTube, he's everywhere on YouTube. He's there every week. And his name is Usual Mike. And for those of you guys that haven't yet subscribed to or even haven't come across Usual Mike Television, then you should. That's going to be your next thing that you're going to do. Usual Mike, how you going?
How are you? Thank you for having me on Star Wars Vault Unleashed. This is Usual Mike Television right here. And we've been on YouTube for 4 years now, I think.
Wow. Mate, I tell you what, the first time I came across your channel would have been about a couple years ago, actually. Mate, I've just loved it. You know, it's just the fact that the way you deliver the news, it's just casual. You know, such a typical Australian sort of culture there. And I love it, Mike.
I make it my own, and it's irreverent, and I try and make it as fun as I possibly can for people to get involved in collecting action figures.
Do you want to just tell us a little bit more about yourself?
Well, I decided to start a YouTube channel when I started university, and I had certain days off, and I thought, on my days off, I'll make YouTube videos. And at the beginning, I did Star Wars, I did Hot Wheels, I did Funko Pops, and I narrowed it all the way down just to Star Wars because it made more sense to me. And I thought, I'm not the greatest reviewer in the world, but I love telling you about the news, the exciting news of stuff that's coming in. I got right into it and I just decided that's where I'm going. It's going to be mostly news. I still do the odd review and things like that, but yeah, news is the funnest part of it because, you know, everyone wants to know what's new and what's coming and what to collect.
Tell us, yes, you did mention that you review quite a few lines of toys out there, but why Star Wars specifically? What got you into Star Wars?
The first action figure I got was in 1984, was a present, and it was Han Solo. And I remember as a kid, the Vintage Collection card back when you're a kid, you have smaller hands as a child, and it looked massive. And I looked at it, and I'm like, wow, this is the guy from the movie that I saw. And me being naive, my mother's like, you're going to open it or what? And from that day, I opened, and then later on down life, I was never to open one ever again.
Wow.
And I just, that nostalgia, that just the look of the card back, the action figure. And from there, it was sporadic because during the 90s, a lot of different lines and things and during the dark times. And what got me back into it was Star Wars coming back as movie properties, like The Force Awakens. And as soon as Black Series started and they're doing the Vintage Collection again, I was deep into it. I'm like, this is the best. Wow. And I stopped other collecting. I stopped collecting Hot Wheels as well. So I just stuck with Hot Wheels ever since then. I was stuck with Star Wars ever since then. And collection has grown.
Have you ever wanted to stop collecting for any reason, like since then until now?
No, because they just consistently give us something new. Even if there's something that Hasbro doesn't, that makes that people don't like, you just move on to the next one and there's something else really good to collect. It's this never ending cycle of goodness. There'll be a dud along the way, that's expected. But yeah, there's a lot of goodness to collect the stuff that they put out.
And it's dangerous, isn't it?
Oh, yes. Very, because you can go down that rabbit hole of just, I want to collect the whole line, the whole sets. Yeah, it's...
Do you want to just take us through what you've got right there at the back and maybe tell us which one is your most favorite and maybe just go through them?
My favorite part of my collection at the moment is up here. This is my Wave 1 and 2 of the Retro Collection. I love these figures, particularly this one because, well, that was my first figure and they've remade it for me. I try and keep this figure. Here is one of my most expensive and I don't think I'll ever part with this one.
Nice.
Mentioning Super Boba Fett. I keep the Mandalorians all here. I'm in love with that show.
Yes.
Through here we have the subset.
The trailer for season 2 just dropped last night, right?
Oh yeah, I've seen it twice now. Very cool. Oh. My deluxe collection. That was one of my, I made that. It's terrible, I know, but I love the card back. It's an original figure, but I've made the card back out of photo paper and glued a bubble to it.
Nice.
This line here with the gaming greats, I really love the gaming great stuff. There's the most recent or the last wave back there of mostly Attack of the Clones sort of stuff. And a final figure, there's the Bounty Hunters collection in there. Love that two-pack. Some carbonized. There's my Kenner. I love my Kenner. I think that's all my figures I have. Out of the first 12, I'm missing the Jawa. They're not in the greatest condition, but I still love them. I still think they're the best. They're early days. One of the rarer pieces that I have in my collection, I have this guy you might remember. He's only worth $15, that particular figure. But I have a miscarded one. As you can see, it's got Kylo Ren. That guy in it. So that's why he's in that special plastic case. I was just putting that there to show you that made a mistake, and I found it on the shelf like that. Not too many of them around.
Nice. Well done.
Here we have... Oh, that's a little collection here. I like this. It's down on the floor. It's not up on the wall.
Yep, the four packs.
They never made one for The Rise of Skywalker. And I'm so annoyed because it's like such a good four pack of each of the films.
Yes.
Never did Rise of Skywalker. Up here is some of my collection of vintage. I know down here that's an original one.
Yes.
That one there. And that's a retro collection exclusive.
Yes.
The Vader. I don't have them in any particular order other than I just put them on the wall and I like them. That's it. And then awesome. Up here I got a couple of my customs of me.
Nice. And,
on this part of the wall is kind of... I still love my collection. This one I always have in my videos because I just love that figure. That for some reason, that Obi-Wan in the Clone Commander, I've got him in a plastic case, so he's got a bit of a reflection on him. I just seem to love that figure so much. I don't know what it is about. It just speaks to me so much. I've never been like the Obi-Wan collector. I've always been Han Solo as my collection, collecting like piece, and I just got that, and I was just like, I love it so much. And my Palpatine here is like chasing away the Porgs. He's like, get off my lawn. A couple of convention exclusives I can show you behind here. Obi-Wan Kenobi.
Yes.
And the other one, Darth Maul.
Yes.
They were the Star Wars Celebration convention exclusives. And then hiding behind there is every archive figure ever made. And they've done all the archive ones, including the really rare everybody wants. Anakin, Commander Gree.
Oh, look at that. Beautiful.
This is probably the most expensive item in my collection. I saw him listed on eBay for $1,000 US, and I was like, are you kidding me?
Wow.
Put too much light on that, yeah.
Well done.
And out the door we go, and you'll see some more. Oh, we can hit the lights too.
Oh, there you go. Guys, there you go. This is the view that we've never seen before, because he's always stuck in a room when he's YouTubing.
So I really like that Solo set. There's a lot of the Black Series. A couple of notable ones I do like is my Grand Moff Tarkin.
Yes.
Lovely figure. One of the hard ones to get, the Jane Solo.
Of course.
And this one, which is Dengar. I love that figure. He's still in the case too. Going across the floor here, they don't live here, by the way. This is just here, just for you. A lot of the vintage collection, everything from pretty much 2018 to now, is more in the tub. And then this way, some more Black Series.
Nice.
So a lot of these exclusives, these ones here, and some of the favorites. That's quite a difficult one to get, that one there.
Yes.
And this one's quite difficult to get as well, Mimban Trooper. I do like that Princess Leia. And up on top of this box is all the
what packaging?
First editions minus the Mando. The Mando's the only one I'm missing from that line.
Mike, you've got a lot of I can see that you've got a lot of empty walls there on the left and the right. That's where it belongs, man.
Oh yeah, yeah. I've got to convince the wife.
Usual Mike, man, I tell you what. Not only it's great to see your face right here as part of episodes, but thank you so much for showing us your collection there. It's so impressive. Are you ready?
Thank you.
Let's jump into the rapid questions. Are you ready?
Ready.
Do you think Star Wars collecting is an addiction?
Yes.
It's crazy, isn't it? We can't stop.
You can't stop. Once that train starts rolling, you can't pull it up.
And I can see it's a good balance between 375-inch character, figures, as well as some of the Black Series as well. Which one do you prefer between the two?
Ooh. That's a very tough question. That's like saying, which child do you prefer? Which of my children is better? There are days where I can see vintage collection being in front because they do so many great... The designs of the card backs are just absolutely spectacular most of the time. But then Black Series comes out of nowhere and goes, we've got a new Carbonized figure. And I'm like, I'm all in. Yeah.
Yeah.
The sublines are sort of what get me.
Do you ever... And be honest, do you ever hide your Star Wars purchases from your missus?
No, because my wife's a collector as well, and she wouldn't hide her stuff, so I don't hide mine.
What's the one item in your bucket list today that you don't have in possession?
I do want a 1983 Return of the Jedi Han Solo in his vest. On card back, the Kenner one. I'd love that. Just, I know that's very, very expensive to get. That was my first figure. And to have this kind of as a replacement, I want the card back and I want it mint. I want it perfect forever. You know, that's not something I'm going to go and flip straight away for money. But yeah, that would be the most perfect thing ever.
What would be your advice? What would be that wise advice from Usual Mike Television about collecting Star Wars?
I do get asked this in my comments too, and the only way I say it is usually young guys who are just starting out, say they're like, you know, between 13 and 17, they want this advice. I want to start collecting Star Wars. Where do I start? Just collect what you like. Just find a figure and just go, I like that. Buy it. If you don't like something, don't worry about it. Move on to the next one. Yeah, just buy what you like and what you can afford, and therefore a collection will accumulate over time before you know it, and then you've got wall to walls of Star Wars.
All right. Well, Mike, thank you so much for your time and for that really great advice that you've shared with the viewers and audience. Like us on Facebook, Instagram, and subscribe to our channel and Usual Mike's Television's channel. Mike, thank you once again for your time and really appreciate it. May the force be with you.
Thank you, Harris.
And I'll see you around the TV.
Thanks,
Mike.